Everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a compilation video of all my favorite decor items from my 4th of July series. So we're going to start out with my favorite number one, which is from episode one, and it's the three-tier tray. And you can see everything in the video that you'll need. In my compilation video, I'm not going to go through every detail of the crafting process. I will link the video up in the card above, and if you guys want to know more in depth on how I do this, then just click the card above and watch the video. So what I did is I basically just painted three stovetop cover burner covers with Waverly chalk paint and white, and then I glued those together using a dustpan pole, and that's how I made this three-tier tray. Like I said, click the card above and you'll be able to see the full tutorial on this. And I just want to thank everybody for supporting me in my first series on my channel. I had a lot of fun doing all these crafts. I enjoyed decorating for the holidays, and this is the first time I really went in-depth decorating for the 4th of July. So I hope you guys enjoy watching it as I did making it. And I want to thank everybody for their support. I mean, you guys were awesome in showing me support in these videos. Even though there were some snags along the way, everybody was still very supportive. And I appreciate that. And I want you all to stay tuned because there's going to be a lot more to come. I've got a lot of neat ideas and I can't wait to bring them to you. So be sure to subscribe, hit that subscribe button so that you can see all of my upcoming videos. And don't forget to hit that notification bell also so that you'll be notified when I do upload, which will be every Monday, Tuesday, and Saturday. I'm just going to take the handle from this dustpan and we're going to cut it to make it fit for the three-tier tray. And you're going to paint that white. And once you have it all put together, you're just going to go over it with some antique wax from Waverly to give it that worn look. So for my favorite number two, it's also from episode one, and it's the red, white, and blue star shadow box. This was so easy to do. You just need a sign from the Dollar Tree, some paint, and then a little wooden puzzle you can get from the toy section of the Dollar Tree. And you're just going to paint three stars, red, white, and blue, and put some scrap paper inside the shadow box. Glue the stars onto the shadow box, and easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And then I ended up putting it on my tear tray. Again, I'll put a card up above to link the video so you can get the full details on how to do this. And there's the three-star shadow box. So for favorite number three, it's the Star Spangled Fireworks from episode 2. I had so much fun doing these, and I got a lot of compliments on these. And they were so easy and budget-friendly to make. You just need three of these round, I don't know what they are, gift boxes from Dollar Tree, some jute twine, some scrap paper, some stars, some nautical rope. And you just paint the stars, you glue the you put paper around your gift boxes. You're going to glue the nautical rope on top to make it look like a fuse with the star at the tip of the fuse. And then that project is finished. Again, I will put a card up above so that you can see the full tutorial of it. This was so much fun to make. I loved making these. And people that came into my home actually gave me a lot of compliments on these, so I think you'll enjoy them as much as I do. And I hope this video gives you, I hope it gives you inspiration and some ideas. I know it's kind of, right now, you're kind of in the home stretch for the fourth, but the favorites I'm showing you in this video are so easy to make that you'll be able to get them done before the fourth, and they'll look good on any, like, party table or centerpieces or anything you want to use as them, or anything you want to use them for. It'll be quick and easy to do. And there they are, all complete. I thought these turned out so good. So for favorite number four, my roses are red, white, and blue jars from episode 3. Again, these are super simple to do, and you can use them for any centerpiece. All you do is just need 3 bundles of these red, white, and blue flowers from the Dollar Tree, 3 jars, some jute twine, a couple American flags, and some red, blue food coloring. Fill the jars up with water, put the food coloring in the jars, arrange your flowers and flag, and you have red, white, and blue jars that make gorgeous centerpieces. I actually had a lot of compliments on these also. Everybody thought it was a cool idea coloring the water. Very patriotic. So for my last favorite number five, it was the American Eagle I did from episode four. And this was so easy to do. You just need a printable of an eagle, a couple sheets of scrap paper, some carbon paper, some foam core board. You trace the eagle onto the foam core board, cut it out, glue it together. You put the scrap paper on, and you have a beautiful, again, you can use it as a centerpiece or you can use it as a backdrop to other decorations, which is what I did. I used it as a backdrop to my tablescape that I made in episode two. Everything on that table I made in episode two. And I just added that to that table. So easy and very patriotic. And it turned out to be one of my favorite things. So I hope you enjoy making it as much as I did. And like I said, super simple. Just be careful not to cut yourself. There you have it. Thanks for watching my final installment in my 4th of July series. Hope y'all enjoyed watching the series as much as I did making it. Don't forget to subscribe so you'll be notified of all my future uploads. And remember the people that fought for the freedom of this country. And have a happy 4th of July, everybody. Bye.